मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लास. दिस इज शीला, योर कंप्यूटर साइंस टीचर. इन लास्ट क्लास वी सॉ द बेसिक्स ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग. इज़न्ट इट? इन दैट वी सॉ व्हाट इज डेटा एब्स्ट्रैक्शन, व्हाट इज पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म, व्हाट इज एनकैप्सुलेशन, व्हाट इज क्लास, व्हाट इज ऑब्जेक्ट्स. ऑल दिस वी सॉ, इज़न्ट इट? एंड लेट अस सी अबाउट क्लासेस एंड ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन डिटेल इन दिस लेसन. चिल्ड्रन, योर पोर्शंस आर रिड्यूस्ड, सो वी विल बी डीलिंग विद 14.1, 14.2, 14.3 एंड 14.4 अलोन. Yes. Yes, children. In C++, these concepts in your abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, and polymorphism are the four main features that is actually important in your C++. So, what is abstraction? All this we dealt in our previous class, isn't it? What is abstraction? Abstraction is dealing with the essential thing and leaving out what is not wanted at that time. That is going to be termed as abstraction. What about encapsulation? Binding of data and functions together into a single unit is termed as what? Encapsulation. What about inheritance? Inheritance is deriving the properties of the base class to the derived class. And what about polymorphism? Ability to take more than one form. Yes. And why do we want this class? Yes. Why do we want a class? Class actually binds the data and functions together into a single unit. It comes under the concept of encapsulation. Yes, and we use this class for creating our own data type. Yes, we have int, we have float, isn't it? The same way, when we wanted to create our own data type, we go for class. So, a class is defined using a word, keyword, class. This is most important concept. So, see to it you people understand everything. Yes, the body of the class is defined inside the curly braces and terminated with a semicolon or a list of declaration at the end. You people will understand what it is actually being told here when you people see a sample code or a syntax. Yes, see here, this is going to be your sample code. What is actually given? It is already told that your class name should always begin with a name called class. Yes, it begins with class name, and you have three access specifiers. I already told you what is access specifier, isn't it? Private, protected, public is going to be termed as what? Access specifiers. You declare variables and you declare functions here. Variable declaration, function declaration. Variable declaration, function declaration. You should have a doubt now. Miss, should we declare all this together in single class? Not like that. Whatever we need, if our class has to be private, we can use access specifier private alone. And if I wanted to, our class name to be protected, class member variables to be protected, I can go for protected. Or if I want a combination of private and protected, can happen. But yeah, they are just representing that variables can be private, protected and public. Functions can be private, protected and public. And they also told you that it has to end up with a semicolon. Yes, this is the syntax for your class. So when a question is being asked about class, you have to define what is class, under what feature does it come, and what is the syntax. And you also should write a sample code. Yes. See, these variable declaration, we will call it as data members, and functions, we will call it as member functions. You should have a doubt now. What is a function? Function, we already dealt, isn't it? It should always have a pod braces. Yes, and it is used for reducing the size of the program. I already told you, yes, there are three types of access specifiers, private, public and protected. See, data hiding is one important concept in your object-oriented programming. Yes, you can do that using these access specifiers, private, protected and public, to restrict the access of class members by other functions. Yes. And you know what is your default access specifier? Your default access specifier is private. This may be asked in one mark. So remember, the default access specifier for members is private. So public members. So what is a public member? Public is accessible from anywhere outside the class but within the program. See, within the program, outside the class, it can be accessed. The member variables can be accessed member functions can be accessed anywhere. You can set and get the value of public data members even without using any member functions. What about private members? Private members cannot be accessed outside the class. Yes, only the class member functions can access the private members. By default, all the members would be called as private. And what about protected? It is very similar to your private. A protected member is very similar to a private member. The one benefit is child can also access the class variables. Yes. What is the child class? Child class is otherwise called as derived class. Yes, we have already seen what is inheritance. Yes, but we did not see the actual concepts. So this is just the basics. See, let us see this with an example. Yes, a class student. Class is a keyword, and the name of the class is going to be student. And here the name is going to be private, roll number, mark 1, mark 2, total, all these are going to be student acts as a class name. Yes, and what it is actually, it is a user defined data type. Yes, using this name we will be creating objects that we will see later. For now, let us see what and all is being declared as private, what and all is being declared as protected, and what and all is being declared as public. So what is there in private? You have name, roll number, mark 1, mark 2, and total. It means it cannot be accessed outside the class. Yes, what about protected? The same, only derived classes can use this, except and compute. What about display? Display is going to be public, it can be accessed from anywhere inside the program. Yes. Definition of class. Your class comprises of members, and members are classified as data members and member functions. We declare int a is going to be a member, and if it is going to be with pod braces some name, then it is going to be your function. Yes, so your class is going to have what? Members, data members, and member functions. Data members are the data variables that represent the features and all the properties of the class. See, member functions are functions that perform specific tasks in a class. So member functions are called as what? They can be otherwise called as methods, and data members can be otherwise called as attributes. Yes, just have a look here. Class result, private, class name, roll number, mark 1, mark 2, all these are data members. Except display and all is termed to be member functions. Yes, member functions is otherwise called as what? Methods. And what about variables? They are termed as what? Data members are otherwise termed as attributes. Defining methods inside a class. I mean your functions inside a class. Without defining methods, class definition will become incomplete. The member functions of the class can be defined in two ways. One is going to be inside the class definition. The other one is going to be outside the class definition. Let us see the difference one by one. So what is inside the class definition? When a class member inside the class definition, when a member function is defined inside a class, how does it behave? How does it behave? It behaves like an inline class. This is called as inline member function. What about outside the class function? When a member function is defined outside the class, it just behaves like a normal function. Then it will be called as outline member function or non-inline member function. And what do? We use scope resolution operator to access the class functions. Yes? See, how do you define your member functions? Yes, return type, name, scope resolution operator, function name, parameter list, and finally function definition. This we define outside the class. Yes, if you wanted to define outside the class member, you should definitely have a scope resolution operator, you should have a return type, and you should have a class name. Clear? See, this is just going to be an example. Void add scope resolution operator display. Display is a member function, it is actually defined inside a class, and add is a class name. Yes, so what happens? And void is going to be a return type. If you're not going to return anything, you can declare it as void. Let us see a sample program for inline and outline member functions. Yes, your class. Class has what? Class has a member variable. What it is actually? Width. Yes. If we don't specify anything, what it is going to be? We did we specify anything here? Nothing, right? When we don't specify anything, what it is termed as? Private. Yes. Next, what do you have? Public. Public. In public, what do you have? You have variable length and function, member function, which is also called as method. Print width. Yes, print width. This is going to be inside the class itself, and this is called as what? Inline member function. And what do you have in it? You have a execution code. Yes. And another one is there. What it is actually void set width of. You can see here void set width of w. Yes, what it is actually, this is also a prototype, this is also a member function, and the definition is given outside the class. You can see here. Yes, so if you wanted to declare something outside the class, what you should have? You should have a return type, you should have the class name, you should have a scope resolution operator and the function name. Yes. What is the class name here? Class box is the class name. Yes. Fine. Now let us move on with the function. Yes. Int main box b. What is this b? B is nothing but what? B is an object that we create for a class box. Box is your class name. And it acts as a data type, isn't it? And what this has to be? The variable that we define for our data type. So, box is going to be a class name and B is going to be an object. So, how can you access the set width using a object? B dot set width 10.0. B dot print width. Yes. So, what happens? 10.0. This will move on to the function. Set width function. What is there? Set width. Width is equal to w. That's it. And print width. What happens? In print width, the width of the box will be printed. That's it. Yes. If class name. That class name is going to be a data type. Yes. And for the data type, we should have certain variables. Yes. Box b. B is a variable, isn't it? That variable we call as object. And we call it as instance of a class. What is an object? Object is nothing but instance of a class. In case, if they are going to ask you what is an object, if you just write instance of a class and if you just give a sample code, I mean a syntax, you will get 2 marks. Yes, student. Yes, student is a class name and yes is an object. So, object can be created in 2 methods. One is going to be local object, the other one is going to be global object. What is global object? If an object is declared outside all the function bodies or by placing their names immediately after the close braces, then it is termed as global object. And what about local object? It is an object that is declared within a function, then it is called as local object. Fine, now let us see an example for it. Yes, class add. Add is a name of a class. Yes, what do you have? AB is a private variable. Public is going to be sum. Yes, then what do you have? You have void get data, and that get data is actually described here itself. And you have a variable here, A1. A1 is a variable that is actually declared immediately outside the inside the class. Semicolon is given after A1 only. That is going to be a global object. Or even here, add A2. A2 is an object. Add is a class name. That is also declared immediately after the class. Then it is called as global object. In case if I am going to define the same variable inside the main, then it is called as local object. See? Inside the main, if I give the class name and if I create a variable, then it is local object. Yes, a1.getData. See, this a, b can be used only by this getData function. Not any function that is outside the class. Yes, why so? Because a and b are private variables. So, a is equal to 5, b is equal to 10, sum of a plus b. as you give a1.getData, the for this a1 object, what happens? This getData function will work. And for a2 object, this getData, the same getData function will work. And for the same a3, the same getData function will work. And if you wanted to print the data, how will you print? Cout a1.sum. Sum is a variable, isn't it? So you can just give. Memory allocation of objects. See, member functions are created and placed in the memory space only when they are defined as a part of a class specification. What is a member function? Member function is actually defined inside a class. Yes, when you define them inside a class, what happens? A memory space will be allocated for them as well. Since all the objects belonging to that class use the same member functions. Yes, any objects that you create, as many objects that you create, all objects are going to use were the same member functions. So, no separate space will be allocated for the member functions when the objects are created. Memory space required for a member variable are only allocated separately for each object, because member variables will hold different data values for different objects. See, no separate space will be allocated for member functions when an object is created. Actually, for member variables, we need what? We need memory space, because for each object, we will be using the same member variables, right? So, the memory spaces will be required. Yes, now let us move on with memory allocations for objects. What do you have? Product as a class name, and you have code, quantity, price, all this is going to be a private variable. Public, you have assigned data and print. These are going to be public, what? Public member functions, or otherwise termed as methods. And these are termed as attributes or data members. So, and here we are creating two objects, P1, P2. Yes. Now what happens? Size of P1 and size of P2 is actually required. So what happens? P1, P2 are the two objects that we are creating. Yes, P1, P2 are the two objects that we are creating. And see out memory allocation of memory allocation for object P1. Here, have we defined any function here? Nothing. We are just getting the size of P1 alone. So what is size of P1? Int takes 4. For code and quantity 4 plus 4 8, and for price it is going to take 4, so 4 plus 4 plus 4, it is going to be 12. The same way for P2 object also, 12 spaces will be created. This is how the memory allocation is done. So with respect to what do we create spaces? With respect to your attributes and not the member functions. See, as I already told you, for P1 object, P2 object, code takes 4 bytes, quantity takes 4 bytes, price takes 4 bytes, totally 12. And the same for P2 object, what happens? Again, a space will be created with 4 bytes each. Yes, so 12 bytes. And final topic is going to be referencing the class members. Class, the members of the class are referenced by using objects of the class followed by a dot. And that is termed as what? Membership operator and the name of the member. So how do you define it? Object name dot function name comma of actual parameter. Object name dot function name of actual parameters. What is actual parameters? The parameters that we are using currently. We don't change it. Yes. See here, stud, S-T-U-D, stud is going to be your object name. Dot is going to be dot operator. It is otherwise called as what? It is otherwise called as membership operator. Execute is a member function. So let us see a sample code for this. Compute. Compute is a class name. N1, N2 are private variables. In public variable you have N, and int A comma B you have what? C is equal to A plus B. Okay, fine. All this is going to be what? An inline member function. And you have two objects here, C1 and C2. So to access the variables, what do we do? C1.N is equal to C1.add of 12 comma 12. A member function is actually called here. C1.N. What is N here? N, a simple variable which is actually declared. So to access for two objects, for C1 and C2. So for doing for C1, what happens? C1 dot n because it's a public variable. So n is equal to add of c1 dot add of int a comma b. So 12 comma 15. What happens? This 12 comma 15 will be passed to. It will not be passed because it's an inline function. It will be expanded here itself. So what happens? A and b will be added and it will be placed in c. And the value will be returned to the main function. C2 dot n. C2 is another object and n is a public variable. C2 dot add of 8 comma 4. For object C2, what happens? Another function will be running. Yes. And the value will be returned. And finally, what do you have? Sum of two objects. C1.n, C2.n. The objects of C1 and the objects of C2. After adding, the values will be added up and the value will be printed here. Yes. Yes, children. This is all the reduced portion for your 14th lesson. We shall stop with this. What did we see for today? We saw what is class, what is object, how do we create objects, what is access specifiers, and how memory allocation is actually done for each and every objects. Yes, children, we shall stop with this and we shall proceed with the rest in the next class. Thank you.